you were honest with me. Now, Jack, I have to be honest with you.
Full honesty, that's our agreement. Yes.
Jack, you have always told me the truth, no matter how painful it was. And last night, that's what I did. I told you the truth. And now this morning, Jack, the truth is...
Well, there they are. My two most favorite people in the whole wide world. Huh?
Oh, Trevor!
That's for what you did to Laurel, you stop.
Trevor, stop it! Stop it, Trevor!
For what you did to Lily.
I can be Eduardo again, see if he can come up with...
And Edmund, I'm glad you brought this up. I've been meaning to say a few words about Kendall for some time now.
She's a pain in the neck.
Well, yes, yes, but I was a pain in the neck, too, and you gave me a second chance, a third chance even, maybe even a fourth and a fifth, and I don't know how many chances I've given you.
Not as many as I had to give you.
Now, where would we be if we hadn't been willing to give each other a break?
So, you really think she's trying her best to make up for all the trouble she's caused?
I'm certain of it.
Okay. I didn't know you felt so strongly about this. I guess I'll try harder.
Edmund, that's all you've got to do.
Excuse me. I heard your voices, so I knew that you were in here. I owe you both an apology.
Now that I've seen your lovely home, I'd do anything to live here. What are your conditions?
Well, I'm a very picky landlady. I mean, my boarders are real nice, but once in a blue moon, you know, every barrel has a rotten apple, and oh, I've had some doozies.
Well, you can trust me. I promise I'd be a good tenant. I need to live here. It's like a home.
Well, it's a home with rules, you know. No smoking. I mean, no smoking in the house. No loud music, no parties, no guests overnight. And, you don't have a long-lost relative who's liable to turn up, do you?
No, I don't.
Oh, thank heaven. Well, all you have to do is pay your rent on time and mind your own business.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, do you have any references?
Yes, my boss is Tad Martin. He said you could call him anytime and he'd vouch for me. And Trevor Dillon, I've been doing some babysitting for him.
Don't say another word. Tad and Trevor are old buddies of mine. And any friend of theirs is a friend of mine. And the room is yours.
You mean it?
Sure. You can move in today.
Great. I've got the money with me in cash.
Honey, you count the cash and I'll make us a cup of tea, okay? Oh, that'll be Tim. He said he'd cut my grass today. Bless his heart. Where are you? Oh, hello, sweetheart. You're early.
Hi, Mr. Morgan. Who wanted early?
Tim, hi. How's my precious Amanda?
Help! No! Get back! No! No, hurry! Get him off me! Harold, no! Get off!
Into the kitchen with you right now.
Bad boy.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Oh, my dear.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I don't think the skin's broken or anything.
Well, Harold never bites anybody.
That's another rule. No pets.
Well, maybe it was my perfume or something.
I'd better give you something for that ankle. A little antiseptic or something. I just want to be on the stage.
No, you don't need to do that.
Well, wait, I don't have any in the house. Listen, I'll get Mrs. Armstrong next door to give me some. I'll just be a jiffy.
Hey, guess what? I'm moving in here. Great.
I think I better go cut the lawn.
Is everything okay? You're not mad because your dog thinks I'm dinner, are you? I don't know what's wrong. I mean, I love dogs. Except for the time I was bitten when I was little. I don't know why the dog doesn't like me. Maybe it's like your father said, he can smell the fear on me.
I won't let him go near you again.
But I love kids and animals. Like you and Amanda and Jamal. You're wonderful. I had so much fun the other night.
I'm nuts about your whole family.
Well, I kind of figured that, you know, considering you and my dad.
Me and your dad? What do you mean?
Well, he said he wants to date you.
He told you we were going to be dating? That's great. I mean, that he talks to you, man to man. Are you okay with that? I mean, about me and your dad? Maybe you feel a little funny. I know. It must be kind of strange. I know you were crazy about your mother.
So was he.
Well, of course. I mean, that's only natural, I'm sure.
They were kind of like made for each other.
That's what I hear. And everybody who knew Natalie Dillon tells me that she was an angel from heaven.
Mom was cool.
Sounds like she was very, very, very special. And those people are impossible to replace. I know that for a fact. I once tried to fill in somebody else's shoes, and it's the biggest mistake I ever made. I mean, you just can't do that, so don't worry about me trying to be your mother. I don't think that way anymore. Okay, Tim? I have to apologize. I was bringing you these papers to sign, and I heard your voices. Enough to realize that somehow I've managed to stir up trouble again, and I want you to know that I'm sorry.
Thank you. What's going on?
I've been trying so hard. I just keep messing up. Dimitri, I love living at the hunting lodge with Anton. I love Anton. And I am so grateful for this job, and I'm so grateful for this roof over my head. I just wish I could stop messing up and landing on your bad side.
Edmund?
No. It's not his fault. I'm the one to blame. Anton keeps on telling me that if you expect people not to like you, they usually won't. I've really been trying not to expect things.
You're trying, all right?
Edmund.
Sorry.
Now, with Corvina here, it's such a great time for me to get to know his family. I want you to know how much I appreciate that.
Well, thank you, Kendall.
I really have been trying. It seems to come out wrong.
Okay. You're not the only one in this house who owes an apology. I have been rude to you. Maria yells at me, and now my brother is telling me that he who is without sin should cast the first stone, and that certainly counts me out. So, peace.
Peace. Gladly. Michi, thank you so much for sticking up for me. You have no idea how good it feels to know that you're willing to give me a second chance.
Well, you're welcome, Kendall.
Your faith in me means more than I can say. Excuse me.
You deserve an Oscar for that one, bro.
You're half bad yourself.
Yeah, for the time being, we have managed to soothe the savage beast.
That was good advice. About not dropping him to Boris. I'll call my attorney and have him ask for a continuance. First, I'm off to tell Erica.
Are you nuts? You want to take this outside?
No, I've got a policy, Trevor. I don't try to encourage the obviously mentally deranged.
Oh, I should have done this before you took off to New York with little Miss Hot to Trot here, before you ruined the best thing that ever happened to your life, your wife. You remember her? You remember Laurel?
You are way out of line, Trevor. That is not
Do you have any idea what you've done to Laurel?
Will you stop it?
Well, I do, because I was just there, Jack. Her life is in ruins. It's a wreck. It's destroyed.
All I want to know is who the hell asked you to stick your nose in
our
business.
You must be feeling pretty damn good, huh? Another notch on the old bedpost.
All right, that's it. Get out!
Look, this caveman approach to a very moderate and complex issue is really stupid.
Complex? No. No, no. It's actually pretty simple, pretty raw.
All right, shut up. That's it. Get out now.
Take me, huh?
You.
Stop it, Felicity. Stop it. Look, if you will just calm down for a minute and stop trying to kill him, you will realize that Jack is not happy about what happened either.
Oh, poor Jackie, baby. You a victim, huh? What about Laurel, huh? You left her in that penthouse alone. Her life is in shreds. And what, you just come right over here, huh? Walk right over here. You didn't waste a second, did you?
At least.
Tim, I'm the new kid in town. The people I've met have been really nice, like your family, especially your dad.
And while it might be swell for us, maybe it's not so hot for you. Maybe you're uncomfortable seeing your father with someone new.
It's okay.
You say that, but maybe it's not. If it bothers you, I just want you to come to me first. So just, you know, air how you feel.
It won't bother me.
But it might. You know, I have a friend who says that Ms. Jaffe says that you can deal with any kind of problem as long as you simply air your feelings. Okay, Tim?
Sure, Jane.
Terrific. Glad we had this little talk.
When Miss Fargate comes back, tell her to start with the backyard.
Okay.
Oh, Harold's in the kitchen, so don't worry about him. He can't get out.
Bye-bye. Something has got to be done about that vicious, mangy mutt. It's got to be dealt with, won't it?
You are bursting into my house like a stormtrooper. You don't even know what happened.
You can't sweet talk your way out of this one, Tootsie. Your brand is all over this sap. I used to respect you. But what you did to Laurel makes me sick.
Who asked you what you think? Who cares?
I care. I don't get you, Jack. And I don't get you. You stood here in this very room the day the jury found you not guilty. You told me there was nothing going on between you two other than friendship, and there never would be. And then what happened? You sneak off to New York to some cheap hotel room so you two can make whoopee.
Tomorrow, Tony meets his match when Ted Shackelford guest stars as a clever killer. Don't miss The Commish. Coming up, is Max playing for the highest stakes of all in his game with Blair? Stay tuned for One Life to Live, next